Hello everyone, welcome to Beat Oxygen Academy. I am Viti Patel. Today's tutorial topic is explicit cursor. Explicit cursors are programmer defined cursors for gaining more control over context area. A cursor is called explicit cursor if it is opened by user to process data through PLSQL block. It is opened by user, so user has to take care about managing cursor. It is used when there is a need to process more than one record individually. Even though the cursor stores multiple records, only one record can be processed at a time, which is called as a current row. An explicit cursor should be defined in the declaration section of PLSQL block. It is created on select statement which returns more than one row. There are several steps to manage explicit cursors, which are declare a cursor, open a cursor, fetching data, processing data, closing cursor. Let's see execution of explicit cursor step by step. First is declare a cursor. An explicit cursor should be defined in the declaration section of the PLSQL block. It is created on a select statement which returns more than one row. A cursor with cursor name is declared. It is mapped to a query given by select statement. Here only cursor will be declared. No any memory is allocated. In example, cursor CACC is declared. Next is opening a cursor. Once cursor is declared, we can open it. When cursor is open, following operation are performed. Memory is allocated to store the data. Execute select statement associated with the cursor. Create active dataset by retrieving data from table. Set the cursor row pointer to point to first record in active dataset. Syntax of opening a cursor. Open cursor name. Using this syntax, cursor CACC is open. After opening cursor, we cannot process selected row directly. We have to fetch column value of a row into memory variables. This is done by fetch statement. Retrieve data from the current row in an active dataset and store them into given variables. Data from a single row are fetched at a time. After fetching data, row pointer is updated to the next row in the active dataset. Variables should be compatible with a column specified in the select statement. In example, data of cursor is fetched into variable using fetch. Next step is processing data. This step involves actual processing of current row by using PLSQL as well as SQL statements like insert, update and delete. A cursor should be closed after the processing of data completes. Once you close the cursor, it will release memory allocated for that cursor. If user forgets to close the cursor, it will automatically closed after termination of the program. For closing cursor, close cursor name syntax is used. Using that, cursor CACC is closed. Cursor attributes is open. It returns Boolean's result true if the given cursor is already open, else it returns false. Form. It returns the Boolean result true if the most recent fetch operation fetch a record successfully, else it will return false. Not form. This works oppositely to the form. It will return true if the most recent fetch operation could not able to fetch any record. Row count. It returns the numerical value. It gives the actual count of records that got affected by DML activity. For example of explicit cursor, refer the given account table, which has three columns, account number, balance and bname, and five records. Let's take an example. We are transferring all the accounts belonging to the VVN branch from account table into the another table ACC underscore VVN having only two columns ACC underscore number and balance. If table ACC underscore VVN is not available, then first create it. In declaration section, cursor is declared within select statement. After that, variable number, balance and branch is declared having anchor data type. In begin section, Open the cursor, then check whether cursor is open or not. Use loop structure to access more than one record. Then fetch data into variables from cursor. Exit from the loop when cursor is empty. If branch name Vivian is found, then insert the record into acc_Vivian table and delete that record from account table. In the else part, if cursor is not open, then message cursor cannot be open is displayed. Let's check the account table through select statement. There are no records available having branch name as a Vivian. Now check the acc_Vivian table. There are two records available. This was all about explicit cursor. If you like the video, press the like button and share the video. If you have not subscribed our YouTube channel BitOxygen yet, then please subscribe the channel. You can also follow us on Instagram. Our Instagram ID is BitOxygen_Academy. Thank you for watching this video.